What's bigger, minus 5 or minus 10? If this feels like a trick question, it's because it kind of is. When I ask my students in class, they're usually split 50-50, and each half looks at the other like they're crazy. One half says, minus 5 is obviously bigger than minus 10. I mean, that's what I learned in math class. And of course that's correct, especially with no context. But I usually ask this question after we finished our units on kinematics and dynamics, so the other half of the class says, yeah, but minus 10 has a bigger magnitude than minus 5. So who's right? Is it another math versus physics difference? Actually, not quite. Remember that in physics, numbers by themselves are meaningless. You always have to specify what physical quantity you're describing. So let's ask the question again, but for a specific quantity. Consider two cars. One is moving with a velocity of minus 10 meters per second, and the other with minus 5 meters per second. Which car has a larger velocity? Well, in this case, the first car is moving faster, twice as fast, in fact, and the sign just indicates that it is moving in the backwards direction, according to your definition. You can easily get rid of the minus sign by turning around and redefining the positive direction. Similarly with force, if one object is experiencing a force of minus 10 newtons and another a force of minus 5 newtons, clearly the first object is experiencing a larger force, which is acting in the negative direction. But what if I asked you, what is bigger, a temperature of minus 10 degrees Celsius or minus 5 degrees Celsius? Well, in this case, minus 5 degrees Celsius is obviously the higher temperature. In fact, saying the magnitude of the temperature is higher for minus 10 Celsius doesn't even make any sense. Or what if I had two bank accounts? One had minus $10 in it and the other had minus $5. Which balance is larger? Yet again, in this case, minus $5 is larger than minus 10 because less debt is more money. We can't just redefine our axes and flip the signs. Wouldn't that be sweet? Just redefine your axes and your debt turns into a positive balance. But unfortunately, that's not how it works, because unlike velocity and force, which have a magnitude and a direction, temperature and bank balances are scalar quantities. And negative signs have very different meanings when they're in front of vectors versus when they're in front of scalars. For vector quantities like velocity, force, momentum, the magnitude tells you how big the quantity is, and the negative sign is an indication of direction relative to your axes. For scalar quantities, on the other hand, the negative sign tells you how far below a reference point or the zero point you are. And the negative sign does not depend on your definition of axes. One of the most important scalar quantities that you learn about in physics is energy. This topic usually comes after doing several weeks of kinematics and dynamics, where you learn about velocity, acceleration, force, displacement, all vectors. At this point, it almost becomes a knee-jerk reaction to think about the magnitude of all quantities, and the transition to working with a scalar quantity can be challenging. Although the phrase, energy is a scalar quantity, is probably repeated dozens of times by every physics instructor everywhere, what that means, practically speaking, especially in relation to minus signs, is often not explicitly discussed. So let's do some examples here to practice interpreting negative energy. Suppose you drop a ball from rest and measure its speed after it has fallen a distance h. We can analyze this scenario using the energy process. If we define the ball and Earth to be our system, then it's an isolated system, no work, and the gravitational potential energy is converted to kinetic energy of the ball. More quantitatively, we often define the ground to be our reference point, where the potential energy is zero. So in this case, the energy bar chart looks like this. Initially, there is positive potential energy and no kinetic energy. And finally, all the potential energy gets converted to kinetic energy. The location of the reference point is arbitrary, though, so we could say that the potential energy is zero at the point of release. In this case, what would the bar chart look like? Well, the initial gravitational potential energy is zero. And as it falls, it decreases, which means it becomes negative, and the kinetic energy is, of course, still positive. Does it make sense to say that the magnitude of the potential energy increases? I mean, the bar is getting bigger. But no, what's important is that it is getting more negative, so it is decreasing. All right, time for the ultimate question, which will really test whether you are interpreting negative energy correctly. In the previous example, we were considering the potential energy of our system for an object near the surface of the Earth. But as the object moves farther and farther away compared to the radius of the Earth, then we have to account for the change in gravitational force between them. Imagine you're climbing a ladder with equally spaced rungs. The increase in potential energy from one rung to the next is greater when you're closer to the Earth than when you're farther away. Because when you're close, you're fighting against a strong gravitational pull, so you're doing more work to lift yourself up, and you take a big energy step every time. As you climb higher, the gravitational force gets weaker, so you have to do less work to get to the next rung. Your potential energy keeps increasing as you climb higher, it's just increasing in smaller steps. In fact, it eventually plateaus. Even though you keep climbing ladder rungs to infinity, your potential energy maxes out at some final value. Okay, remember that we can define our reference point, or the zero point of potential energy, to be wherever we want? So where should we put it? By convention, we put it all the way up here at the top of the staircase. So if you climb the stairway to heaven all the way up to infinity, you finally reach zero. I'm sure there's some profound meaning hiding in there somewhere. There's lots of very good reasons for this potentially confusing convention, one of which is that it makes the mathematical expression for the potential energy simple. U is equal to a negative constant times the mass of the Earth times the mass of the object divided by the distance to the center of the Earth. The minus sign means that, as expected, the energy is always negative. So, are you ready now to test your understanding of negative energy? Here's the question. Suppose an object is released from rest at some distance r1 and falls towards the Earth until it reaches a final distance r2 less than r1. Draw the qualitative energy bar chart, like we were doing before, for these before and after states, using the Earth plus object as your system. I'll get you started. Initially, the gravitational potential energy is some negative number, and there is no kinetic energy. What are the final bars? I recommend you pause the video here to take a moment to think about this for yourself. Once you're ready, come back and we'll discuss. Here's a very common answer I get for this question. See if you agree or not. In the final state, the object has gained some kinetic energy, so that bar must be positive. So the final state must have less potential energy than the initial state, which I represent like this. What do you think? If you agree with this bar chart, here's a quick hack I recommend you use for any bar chart to make sure it is consistent or that it makes sense. Assign sample numbers to each bar to see if your final equation makes sense. For example, say this initial bar is -5. The final kinetic energy is +3, and the final potential energy bar is -2. Does the equation -5 = -2 + 3 make sense? No. What must the final potential energy be to make the equation work out? -5 = x + 3. X must be -8. So the bar must go all the way down to there. But wait. Didn't we agree that the potential energy must decrease? Why are we drawing a bigger bar? Remember, energy is a scalar. And for scalars, -8 is less than -5. The size of the bar, or the magnitude of the energy, has no meaning. I sometimes find that thinking about energy in analogy with money is really helpful. Suppose that the potential energy is your savings account, and the kinetic energy is your checking account. Initially, you owe $5 in your savings account and have no money in your checking account. You do a transaction, and in the end, you have $3 in your checking account. Where did that money come from? Well, you took it from your savings account, which now has a balance of -8. Phew, that was a really long-winded way of saying energy is a scalar quantity. But seriously, those negative signs can get really tricky. Just remember that for vectors, the magnitude tells you the size, and the negative sign indicates direction. Whereas scalars do not have a magnitude, and the negative sign indicates how far below you are from zero. If you find yourself getting confused, just think about money. See you next time.